In eastern China, there's a giant dumpling the size of a bagel that's filled to the brim with soup and a lot of crab roe.
我们这边做的最大的汤包，我们做的是，500克的汤包，一个。按照标准的话，我们现在这个六个汤包的标准是140克左右。汤包的皮子相对比较薄，里面的汤汁味道非常鲜美，馅料呢油而不腻，一个字棒。
So how does the soup get inside, and how do you eat this thing? When it comes to Chinese food, few dishes are as recognizable as the bao. Simply put, it's a dough wrapper with filling. But there are so many variations in China that you can do a whole series on it. So, for this season of Eat China, we'll look at 10 different baos and show you how they're made and the story behind them. We're still in eastern China. Apart from the regular sized soup dumplings you find in most places, there's also this, a giant soup dumpling called tangbao that's made with soup, pork, and lots of crab roe. Legend has it that it was invented in the 3rd century, but it really became popular in the 18th century when a Chinese emperor visited the region, loved it, and told everyone about it. Soup dumplings come in all shapes and sizes, and this one is about twice as big as a standard xiaolongbao. It still needs a delicate skin, but it should also be strong enough to hold all the soup.
我叫妙祥红，我是江苏晋江红印酒楼的一名汤包师傅。Miao
has been making giant soup dumplings for over 2 decades.
我是19岁，跟晋江汤包名师万晋学徒。我们这个面粉是用的那个广州产的那个牡丹粉，因为它这个粉它筋比较大，我们要求就是要高筋粉。这个下机到搅拌机里边去搅，搅到它光滑之后，再上。 压面机压.
The dough is left to rest. Meanwhile, Miao works in the filling, which is mostly made with crab roe.
现在我们的那个螃蟹，大多数都是一个供应商。原来是我们那个计划经济时代的时候是毛蟹是100笼15斤，现在发展到我们现在就是蟹肉100笼将近30斤了，这是一个巨大的区别。 它这个中华龙虾蟹呢，它这个吃的嘴里啊，它这个蟹肉它有一股甜味。这个一般的螃蟹，我们看它的质量的话，只是你看这螃蟹是不是活的，死的螃蟹肯定是不能用，这绝对不能用。The
crabs come from lakes along the Yangtze River. They're usually raised on farms such as this one. Crab season runs from September to December. They can be eaten on their own or cooked into various dishes.
这个我们这个先捡螃蟹，螃蟹捡回来呢，要上笼屉蒸熟，大约18分钟时间。这个在这个车螃蟹呢，这个程序也是比较多的，大约十几道工序。把这个螃蟹肉拆下来之后，再
Then it's time to make the filling.
我们再把那个肉皮上面的多余的脂肪全部去掉，再和那个老母鸡大桶骨汤一起熬，熬大约总计大约在6个小时左右，出来出锅之后呢，让它再自动冷却。Pig
skin is full of collagen. When it's cooked, the collagen breaks down. And when it cools, it solidifies into gelatin. But heat it up again and it will melt into a soup. The gelatin is crushed and mixed together with the crab meat, roe, and a tiny bit of pork. The crab is the main attraction. the pork adds an extra depth of flavor. Then it's time to assemble the actual soup dumpling. First, the skin is rolled out.
做汤包的时间大约在我学了两年时间，因为不是你看着很简单的每道工序，你比如现和面、搓条、放气，你没有一定的时间沉淀和那个实践，你肯定是做不了。
So, how do you eat it? Contrary to popular belief, definitely not with a straw.
这个用气管呢，这是这个汤包的温度里边的汤料温度很高的。为什么呢？用气管的时候，当气管你用力的时候，一下子把汤包里边那个里边的汤吃进去的时候，可能会烫到你的气管。 在嘴里边就可能自己控制自己的温度，好像是吃的多一点少一点，慢慢的吞下去。我们这个汤包晋江有这个口诀，就是轻轻提，快快移，先开窗后喝汤，最后一勺光。汤包这个变化是。 很大的，我学徒的时候，那个时候一天我们做了100笼到200笼的样子。我们现在正常的，平常正常的最少的还得一天做200笼。这个随着这个社会经济的发展，吃汤包的人，原来是一种奢侈品，现在就是一种像普通老百姓，只要老百姓都能吃，这就是社会发展好。
Up next, we'll head to Hong Kong, where we'll learn how to make char, a fluffy steamed bun with sweet barbecue pork. Stay tuned.